Hello everyone, and welcome to the FRAN, Miami Fierce and Lovely Art Network. Today we are at the Corner Bar, and we have four guests. The show today is all about poetry and writing. Our first guest, Oscar Fuentes, the Biscayne poet. Second guest, Richard Blanco, Parker Phillips, and...
Marie Whitman.
And Marie Whitman. And now we are gonna go straight or direct to Mr. Oscar Fuentes, the Biscayne poet, and he can't stop typing.
Wow, the city desk.
Totally. Hi, Oscar.
How are you guys?
Honey, that's the guy you're in love.
I'm always in love.
Always in love, right? That's a great answer. I love it.
I'm in love with the city, and I'm in love with Biscayne Bay and like the romanticism of the boulevard. So I do write about the bay,
okay.
The boulevard, and you know, the city is my muse, and I'm in love with the woman of Miami.
So she is Earth, Bay, the beauty of Miami, the ocean, and all that. I remember you, because we know each other for, you know,
yes.
for a long time. Now, these were babies.
Since we were babies.
You know, since your 20s.
Kind of.
Since I was straight.
Now, I see one picture here, you know, South Beach and all that, and then I see you on TV, you know.
Yeah.
Inauguration day. And I go, oh my God, Richard!
The whole ceremony is, and then the president's speech during that inauguration where he mentioned gay for the first time ever that a president has said that in an inaugural address. I was very moved. You know, you feel this beautiful moment, and it's not necessarily because it's whether you like Obama or don't like Obama. It's not any. It's almost not political. It's this moment where America comes together, mm-hmm. and it felt sacred, like almost mm-hmm. like a wedding, mm-hmm. like that says, we are here to bear witness to this every 4 years to say this is who we are as a country. So I was thinking the same thing you were saying about that apprehension. I was like, what if somebody like wants to shoot me while I'm up there, you know, or something crazy like that, but you know, crossed my mind. But then I started having fun with it, and I thought, maybe if they just like sort of hit my shoulder and I fall in Obama's arms and you know, and I thought, okay, Richard, that's a little egotistical. I think if the president stands up there, they got the security covered.
I think it's extremely nice to see a figure like you going out there and telling them that it's okay, or look what I can do.
I think that's part of the role that that's been happening. And of course there, it concerns me because I think now, you know, we've made a lot of advances in marriage equality, but just because a state passes marriage equality or gay marriage doesn't mean everything's fine. You write about a kid thinking about his sexuality when he can't even have that conversation in his head. He has no language. He won't admit the word gay doesn't happen.
Well, it doesn't happen. You don't know.
Yeah. And I wanted to bring that out because I don't think that people who are not gay really understand that psychology. You don't have that, hoping that somehow this is all gonna go away in some ways mm-hmm. because it's so
what's
terrifying. What's wrong with me? You've kissed your first girl maybe and you're like, oh, maybe it's not the right girl. Maybe that's why I didn't feel anything.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, you like try not to look, you know, at some man that you think is attractive, you know. But then you next time you look a little bit more.
What does Los Cocuyos mean?
Los Cocuyos?
Exactly.
You want to answer?
Fireflies.
They're from, there used to be a lot of Miami, but as Miami has become less rural, but
right.
back in Huachete, in Westchester, when we moved to Westchester, that was the end of Miami.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember growing up as a kid, and then Cuba, so it's a tropic, subtropic kind of species, and their eyes light up. But it's also the name of my uncle's Cuban bodeguita, que se llama El Cocuyito en el libro.
You still teaching?
I'm not teaching.
No?
No. I taught for about 5 years, and I loved teaching. Now I actually started a little business, and it's a small dungeon, actually, in Miami.
I love that. We have no basement here.
So it's a 1,500 square foot space. I have a bunch of equipment like St. Andrew's crosses, mm-hmm. spanking benches. I have an electric winch where I, you know, tie people up to a spreader bar and spank them and tease them. So I do sessions as a dominant.
See? Hello, everyone. And here we are with Mary Whitman. What did you write about when you were like a kid?
Everything. I mean, I have one silly memory of one year that my mom had announced that we would not be getting a Christmas tree. And I was just devastated, you know, and went into my room and wrote this, like, you know, really intense poem about what's Christmas without a Christmas tree. So I was a very emotional child, very dramatic child. Sometimes people will, I'll say, give me three words and I'll create a poem. Sometimes they'll give me a topic and I'll create a poem. And sometimes they'll say, it's your choice, create whatever you feel. It's really just a feeling like no other. It feels like a service. Mm-hmm. For lack of a better word.
Good service.
Yeah.
Well, this was Flan Miami. Mary Whitman, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.